Hello, today I'm going to work on another stage home demo. I have the stage home pro theme installed on the server and I'm going to change this demo that we have into a different site. And to do that, I'm going to use Live.Soda.Buy's website as an inspiration. I'm going to get some of their branding and some of their content, and I'm going to customize the demo that we have here and going to turn it into a different website. As you can see, I already had the demo imported. We imported this with the one-click setup, the one-click demo import that comes with the Switch Home Pro theme. And I also installed the recommended plugins, which are the TimePNG and the Instant Images plugin. So we are pretty much set and ready to get started with the customization of the site. So the first thing that I'm going to do is download some images. I'm going to use the Instant Images plugin to do it. And as you can see on Live.Soda.Buy site, they have a lot of pictures. And they like pictures of houses and just real estate related pictures. But they also have on their site pictures of the Colorado state, pictures of mountains and stuff like that. So I already downloaded some pictures of the Colorado state, but I'm going to search for a few real estate related pictures because I haven't downloaded them yet. So I'm just going to look for some homes and some pictures. These are all pictures from Unsplash, so we have a lot of pictures that we can download here. So now that I downloaded some house pictures, I'm going to download a few more Colorado pictures so we have enough of them to test and play with the design a little bit. Just waiting for everything to download and resize. Okay, so now I am going to start working on the homepage. The first thing that I'm going to do is change the colors, and I'm going to color pick a highlight color for the homepage. I'm going to color pick this blue and place it on the highlight color setting of the customizer. I'm just going to see how it looks, and I'm going to choose a light gray for the base color because I think it will have a nice contrast with the blue. You can see on their site that they have a lot of grays. So we could use a light gray that is a little bit dark but still light, so it contrasts well with the highlight color that we picked. I'm just going to choose for a little darker gray. So it's a lot different now. I'm going to change now the text color for a really dark gray that it's almost like black, but still on this gray color scheme. Now I'm going to change the front page H text color because we have now the setting, since not all highlight colors will work well with the text color that we chose, like we can see on this demo. The almost black text color that we chose wouldn't work with this blue that we picked for the highlight color. So I'm picking a lighter gray so it can be readable. And now I'm going to change the site identity options. I'm going to change their logo that I downloaded. And I'm going to skip cropping. It will probably fit very well if you don't crop the image that you choose. Then I'm just going to change the site title and the tagline. Okay, so now we can work on the hero section. I'm going to start changing the background. I'm going to test a few pictures with The hero section, I'm going to test this one first because I think it's a pretty picture and it has nice colors. Then I'm going to test another one that I really liked as well, that I think is going to work better because it's more bright and it has more colors of the color scheme we are working with. So I like this one better, so I'm going to keep that. And now I will work a little bit on the content that we have. As you can see on Live Soda by Site, they have a bunch of listings, so I'm just going to start on working with that. I will skip the search bar because we already imported one with the demo. And we have these widgets here that we import. They are widgets that come for a plugin that we have, but there are also widgets from Ajax Broker. But in case you don't have the plugin that styles them like this, we can also use a widget from Ajax Broker itself. I'm going to add one here. It's the property showcase one, and it comes style to work with the Sweet Home theme. I'm going to call it feature properties, like on their site. Then I'm just going to change the configuration of it a little bit, change the title and change the amount of properties that I want to show. I'm just going to choose 3 because we don't need a bunch of demo properties showing on the site, since we have a lot of other listings that we're going to set as well. I'm changing this one to be the open house listings. Okay, so now I'm going to copy their text. We already imported a demo text widget, so I'm just going to change the title and I'm going to copy their text, but I'm going to cut a lot of it because since this is just a demo, we don't need a lot of text in this section. I'm going also to center this because this widget, it doesn't come centered as the standard style anymore because some clients may want to use it differently and without this centered style on it. But first I'm just going to change the places. Now I'm going to center the text. Okay, so now I'm going to work on this last row. They have a row that has 3 columns and each of the columns is a little call to action. So I think I'm going to use the Font Awesome widget for this, but instead of the 2 column version it has that comes with the demo, I'm going to use the 3 column one. So each of the column will be a link. So I'm just going to copy the text of each link on each color. The great thing about this widget is that, for example, if you want to use just the link aspect of it, you don't want to use a title or a description for the column, you don't need to, the widget will work pretty well. And this is what I'm doing now. I'm just adding a link and a link title that I want to use with an icon. Okay, so now that I added the links and the link titles, I'm going to open a Font Awesome cheat sheet. This cheat sheet that we have it linked on the setup guide, so you can look for icons there that you can use with the Switch Home theme. For the market reports, I'm just going to use a little house icon. I'm just going to add a little home. Then I'm going to change. I'm going to look for an icon for the Live magazine. I'm using a bookmark, like the one I found on the cheat sheet. Then I'm going to search for an icon for the news. I'm going to copy this class and I'm going to paste it on the icon coding board. Okay, so now that we're ready, I'm going to move on to their footer. The section before their footer. I'm going to change their logo. I have their logo downloaded here, so I'm going to upload it to WordPress. Okay, so now we have a call to action below the logo. So since they have their phone here, I'm going to add it to their call to action that was imported with the demo. Then I'm just going to paste it here and add a little call to action that is related to the phone that we copied. They have a lot of social links, so we are going to the back end of the Switch Home Pro and we are going to add the links there, so all of the links show up on the footer. I'm just going to set some mockup links just so you can see how the icons will work and how they will show up with the theme. Okay, so now that I have added their social links, I'm going to look for some pages that I can link to the homepage that we have. I'm going to use the Features Page widget to showcase them on the homepage. I'm going to use the About Us page and the Services page that they have. So first I'm just going to change the widget that we have left for the listings, and I'm going to call it Resort Listings, which is a listing that they have on the home page. Then I'm just going to clean up this text widget a little bit. There was some error with the formatting of the text, so I'm just fixing that and I'm deleting some of the text like we would do. So as you can see, we already have two featured pages created and we imported them. So I'm just going to change the title and the featured images just so we don't need to link them again. We can just use the ones that we imported. So I'm looking for them on the pages section. So on the About Us page, they have all of the brokers, and on the Services page, they have a section to talk about Colorado and moving to Colorado. So we have a few pictures of Colorado already, so I'm just going to search one for their About Us page. Just going to choose a simple picture. So now I am going to edit the pages. I'm changing their title. Then I'm going to change the featured image. For this one, I'm choosing the picture that I just downloaded. Actually, for this one, I'm going to choose a Colorado picture. And for this one, I am choosing the picture that I just downloaded. Then I'm going to update the pages. And now that I'm done with updating the pages, I'm going to refresh the customizer. And I'm going to see how they look. And now I'm just going to remove the widgets that I don't want to use. This one, I think I'm going to get a link from the homepage and turn it into a call to action. I'm going to use the link that they have on before their search bar. I'm just going to copy this and link to their searches. So now I'm going to work on the content of the hero section. They have on their site a phrasing that says something like, "We are Colorado." So I'm going to use that, and I'm going to use this other phrasing that they have on the slider. And I'm going to copy it here. So now that we are done, I'm just going to the widget page on the WordPress backend because I have to change places of the widgets. I'm going to put the listings first and then the content after, like they have on their site. I'm doing it here because it's easier and faster, but you can do that on the customizer as well if you want to see real time how it's going to look. Okay, so now I'm just going to the homepage again. This is pretty much how it's going to look. And the last thing that I'm going to change is the footer background. I'm going to choose a darker footer than the one we have. And I'm going to choose a picture that is related to the demo's content. I'm going to choose another Colorado picture. I'm going to look for a picture that is darker, so we can contrast well with the light breeze color that we chose. And I think I'm going to crop it because the footer is really small and the picture is quite big. So it will just be best to crop it so I can choose exactly the area that I want of the photo. So now that it's uploaded, I'm going to take a look of how the image was cropped. I'm going to publish it. And I'm not going to work much on the content. I'm just going to leave the content that we imported, but when you're working on your website, you can just go ahead and use the pages that you already imported and change their content. So you don't need to create any pages. This is how the site is looking. This is what we have. All of the listings, some content, some call to actions. And this is basically how we can turn a Switch Home Pro website into a different design and a different website.